This is a coach. It is a model of a typical heavyweight coach used in the United States from the 1920s and 1930s. This is a sleeping car, and it's a model based upon a New York Central prototype and would have seen service from the late 30s until the early 60s. Both of these coaches are American prototypes, but not made by an American manufacturer. No, these were made by an Italian company, Rivarossi. If that name seems familiar, you may have seen my video where I smack talk Rivarossi's large articulated locomotives. Just like those locomotives, these cars are pretty standard for their time, but unlike those locomotives, a lot of them still have pretty good merits today. Let's start with the first set to be released, the heavyweights. Rivarossi began producing heavyweights in 1964 when they introduced the Combine, Pullman Coach, and Observation Coaches in a green Santa Fe livery to their lineup. The Combine matched the Santa Fe prototype, and the Pullman and Observation were based upon standard Pullman builds. All three coaches were almost entirely plastic with plastic wheels. All three ride on the same plastic three-axle trucks and would have had an X2F horn hook coupler mounted to the truck. The trucks are stuck to the body with small pins inserted through the bottom, and I have modified these coaches with body-mounted coupler boxes and KD couplers for the sake of compatibility with modern locomotives. In 1966, Rivarossi would introduce two more coaches to the lineup, the Diner and another form of coach. Once again, these coaches are almost all plastic, weigh very little, and ride on three-axle trucks. They would also begin to offer more road names and liveries after this point, starting with a Pennsylvania Railroad set in 1967. My set I have here is a complete 1977 Central New Jersey Blue Comet set, with five coaches. Rivarossi offered coaches both as single items and as part of a train set featuring a blue CNJ-painted USRA Heavy Pacific and four coaches. That's right, four coaches. The Pullman coach was not included in this set. Rivarossi would introduce two more coaches in 1985, the duplex sleeper based upon a Pennsylvania prototype and the RPO based upon a standard Pullman design. The last car they'd introduce would be the baggage car in 1987. Really? Once again, based on a standard Pullman design, why did it take this long to get a baggage car? All coach types were produced for all roads, so you can in fact find a Blue Comet duplex sleeper for that lengthy 3-hour trip. Mine have no interior detail, but some Rivarossi coaches have been known to come with interior detail from the factory. In 1966, Rivarossi would introduce their first lightweight, streamlined coaches based upon American prototypes. Based upon New York Central cars, Rivarossi would release the Roomette coach, RPO, and Observation cars in three different liveries. In 1967, the Vista Dome would join the roster, and I have one right here in Lackawanna, gray and red. The Vista Dome always had an interior on the top dome, although many releases would not include a full downstairs interior. The cars, once again, ride on plastic trucks, although two-axle design this time, and they were held into the body with a small pin, much like the heavyweights. In 1973, Rivarossi introduced four new lightweight coaches to round off the roster. These coaches were the duplex sleeper, based upon a Pullman design, the chair coach, baggage, and the diner. All presumably based upon New York Central designs, although I cannot be sure for some of these. My set is a much later release than my Blue Comet, being a 1998 release. This is most of the American Orient Express set. I am missing the baggage car and the two accompanying locomotives. This set is interesting as the American Orient Express was very much in service when this set was produced, and the locomotives included in this set were pure fantasy. The train never had dedicated locomotives, and the photo in the box may have been edited from the time some CSXF units pulled the train. The cars I own are three roomettes, a diner, and an observation car. These are much more modern releases of the cars, and pretty much how they were before Rivarossi went into receivership in 2003. The key thing different on these later cars is the added weight and the inclusion of metal wheels. Rivarossi in the 80s and 90s modified a lot of their existing catalog with better motors, detail, and better weight. The best example I can think of is the overhaul to the USRA Heavy Pacific for a special B&O release. The overhaul included a brand new smokebox door, new bell placement, and backhead detail now that the new motor wasn't sticking out the back. Back to the Orient Express, this was sold as a premium Rivarossi set, so the coaches have actual interiors and they actually look pretty good. When put onto a modern layout, they still look quite good, and in my experience, they track reliably and look great behind a variety of equipment. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for my heavyweight Blue Comet set. The extra weight and metal wheels of the Orient Express cars is enough to turn these terribly rolling cars into reliable cars that track well. Just a little weight above the trucks, and when running on some borrowed 33-inch metal wheels, they seem to track just fine. It should be noted that I should be using 36-inch metal wheels, but the Rivarossi flanges are oversized and they have to fit smaller wheels so they don't rub on the brake shoes. These coaches continue to be popular even to this day, almost 60 years after their introduction. And it's no wonder. They came in many colors and for just about any railroad you could imagine. They're certainly not top-of-the-market coaches by any means, but even next to this modern-day Walther's coach, they still look good. Most of them are going to need a little work, but that's expected of some of the cheapest coaches on the market. After all, isn't working on your trains part of the fun?